There's been a lot of talk in the recent past about social media and its crackdown on the flow of information. And I have defended some of these companies and I have gone after some of these companies. Of all the social media companies, I've defended Facebook the most. But that doesn't mean that the system that Facebook has set up for fact-checking is not unbelievably skewed and actually quite dangerous. I'll give you two examples today. So Facebook set up this system. The system is that if you get dinged by one of their designated fact-checkers, they will censor your ad, right? They will remove your ad. Well, what happens if the fact-checkers that were designated are left-wing? So PolitiFact is not a fact-checker. PolitiFact is a left-wing outlet. It is like a Media Matters left-wing outlet. It is designed to fact-check implications. PolitiFact will do these fact-checks where they will fully admit right in the body of the article that what they are fact-checking is not factually false. They'll just say that we don't like the implication, therefore we rate it mostly false. PolitiFact is an overtly political outlet. The fact that they masquerade as an objective fact-checker is a joke. This has been true for literally years. Now, I remember several years back, I cut a video in which all I did was just read statistics from Pew Global Polling on the feelings of Muslims globally about a wide variety of controversial issues ranging from support to terrorism to support for honor killings and all this. I read all of this. That was the entire video. The entire video was just noting what percentage of Muslims in like Afghanistan believed in honor killing and then saying, this seems like an extreme belief. That was the entire video. PolitiFact rated the video false because they said that my standards for extremism were not objective standards of extremism, which is not in fact a false rating. That is just them saying they disagree with my definitions. Okay, that's called a political argument. PolitiFact does this stuff all the time. All the time. And the fact that Facebook decided to use PolitiFact as one of its trusted fact checkers leads to perverse results like this. And there are now two separate ads that have been taken down after being declared quasi-false by Facebook. So the first ad came from the America First PAC. This is one of Donald Trump's super PACs. So it's not related to the Trump campaign. A super PAC operates independently of the campaign. So this is not Trump himself. This is the America First PAC. It's run by Linda McMahon. Okay, so the super PAC ran this ad. As you are about to hear, the ad is completely accurate. There's nothing wrong with this ad. The ad makes a simple claim. Joe Biden is going to raise your taxes. That's the entire claim. PolitiFact rated the ad mostly false. It was removed from Facebook on the basis of PolitiFact's bullcrap fact check. So here is this ad.
Sometimes politicians accidentally tell the truth.
Guess what? If you elect me, I'm not going to have you. Your taxes are going to be raised, not cut.
And it's true. The New York Times says Biden's tax increases are more than double Hillary Clinton's plan. Even the Tax Policy Center admits taxes would increase on all income groups.
If you elect me, I'm not going to have you. Your taxes are going to be raised, not cut.
Big tax increases crushing our recovery.
It could go higher.
America First Action is responsible for the content of this advertisement.
There's not a single word of that is false. In fact, the ad itself cites its sources, right? Throughout the ad. So PolitiFact, the ad launched August 4th. It was then slapped with a mostly false rating by PolitiFact. And then it was blocked by Facebook, like full on blocked by Facebook. Again, the ad directly quotes Biden saying, if you elect me, your taxes are going to be raised, not cut. So how exactly did PolitiFact rationalize its mostly false rating? They accused the PAC of not giving the audience enough context and giving the wrong impression about what Biden meant. So it's a context check, okay? Nothing in there is actually false. They say that it is lacking context, which normally we would call like the basis for a political discussion or argument, right? If you cite to me a fact and I say, listen, here's what you're missing. You're missing this particular context. It doesn't mean that what you are saying is overtly false. It means that I believe that you are not placing it in the proper context, right? That's how a lot of political conversations go. But PolitiFact rated it mostly false. So here is how their stupid fact check begins. They say a new ad from a pro-Trump super PAC uses out-of-context footage of Joe Biden to claim that the former vice president wants to raise taxes for Americans across the board. While the America First Action ad presents that remark out of context, some tax experts estimate that Biden's plan would mean higher taxes on average for all income groups. But those increases would be relatively small for all but the biggest earners. So in other words, they say that while it's true that Biden is going to increase taxes for everyone, he's mostly going to increase taxes for rich people. Therefore, the ad is mostly false. That's insane. So you're admitting that the ad is true. You just agree with Joe Biden's policy. And so you're going to declare the ad mostly false. That's a bullcrap fact check. It's just not true. So PolitiFact declared it mostly false based on the fact that they actually agree with Joe Biden's policy. That isn't even the worst case of Facebook removing something based on a bullcrap PolitiFact fact check. Okay, the worst case is there is a group that is called the Americans Principles Project. The American Principles Project ran an ad in Michigan. Okay, this ad in Michigan targeted the governor of Michigan because the governor of Michigan backs the so-called Equality Act. And the so-called Equality Act essentially abolishes the ability of biological women to compete against only biological women in sports. The Equality Act suggests that if you're a man and you say that you are a woman, you should now be able to compete with women in sports. Right? Transgender women should be able to compete with actual biological women in sports, which of course destroys women's sports because now you have biological males competing with biological females. In a second, I'm going to show you this ad. Then I'm going to tell you what the PolitiFact fact check said. This ad was taken down from Facebook. This is unconscionable stuff. Again, there is nothing that is inaccurate about this ad. Nothing. It was pulled down because PolitiFact, a biased source, is used in the algorithm for Facebook. Facebook should change its algorithm. There's no doubt about it. Honestly, they should bar PolitiFact from being part of the program for gaming the system. I think Facebook's core assumption is that PolitiFact is going to act like a fact checker, not like an arm of the Democratic Party. But apparently that assumption was incorrect. It should never have been made. I mean, PolitiFact has always been an arm of the Democratic Party. In any case, here's the ad that was banned.
All female athletes want is a fair shot at competition, at a scholarship, at a title, at victory. But what if that shot was taken away by a competitor who claims to be a girl but was born a boy? Senator Gary Peters and Joe Biden support legislation that would destroy girls' sports. They call it equality. Really? That's not fair. Not fair at all. Vote against Gary Peters and Joe Biden. They are too extreme for Michigan.
Okay, that's Senator Gary Peters. The ad is against it. There's everything about that ad is true. Every single word about that ad is true. It is, of course, true. I mean, this has become the basis for lawsuits in places like Connecticut, where transgender athletes are competing against biological women and they are destroying them. Because it turns out that if you grow up as a boy, you have a different physiological structure than growing up as a girl. Of course. I know biology. This stuff's super controversial. So the science is real, crowd on the Democratic side. Okay, so here's PolitiFact's fact check that caused Facebook to take this down. Quote, their specific criticism is that allowing transgender girls and women to compete on the basis of their gender identity would create an uneven playing field for student athletes and ultimately end girls and women's sports. Quote, that's a prediction we can't fact check. That's a prediction we can't fact check. So they overtly say they can't fact check the position. It doesn't matter. Because they say that the ad is lacking context, it's missing context, Facebook removed it. So PolitiFact says we can't fact check the ad. And Facebook's response is, okay, we'll take it down. Okay, this is getting to be quite ugly, right? This is the kind of stuff where it only works on one side, by the way. If you are a Democrat and you say that Donald Trump is removing mailboxes from the streets to prevent mail-in voting, so to steal the election, they won't remove any of that crap, any of it. And it's not just Facebook, obviously. We're seeing this on YouTube as well. It's crazy. I mean, you now have a complete grip on the flow of information. Another example. So last night, Tucker hosted on his show a Chinese scientist. This Chinese scientist has claimed that the virus was produced in a Wuhan lab and then released. And now, I don't know whether that's true or not. You don't know whether that's true or not. YouTube doesn't know whether it's true or not. Nobody knows whether it's true or not. It doesn't matter. YouTube took down the video. And so did Facebook, by the way. Here's Tucker Carlson talking about that last night.
But it's clear that Dr. Li Minyang is a serious person. She is making a very serious claim. So within a few hours of her interview last night, a video of the segment reached 1.3 million people on Facebook. And why wouldn't it? The coronavirus pandemic has touched the life of every American. And justifiably, people want to know where it came from. But Facebook still doesn't want you to know that. So Facebook suppressed the video, presumably on behalf of the Chinese government. Facebook executives made it harder for users to watch our segment. Those who found the video had to navigate a warning that the interview, quote, repeats information about COVID-19 that independent fact checkers say is false.
Okay, this standard is the problem. Okay, which independent fact checkers? Who are these independent fact checkers and why should we trust them? Okay, you have to fact check the fact checkers. Because not all fact checkers are created equal, as we have seen. They will overtly rate false claims that are clearly true. Right? There's two separate ads just in the last week that have been removed that are overtly true and that the fact checker itself admits are basically true. This is dangerous stuff. It is. And if these companies wish to remain independent and they don't want everybody just rushing to the government for a solution, which, again, I am against. I don't think the government should step in these cases overall. It's going to be real difficult for the government not to step in at the behest of people who believe that their rights are being violated by social media companies that are, at the very least, quasi-fraudulently claiming to be open and objective participants in a platform rather than in some sort of publication. And I'm against that sort of legislation. But you got to make it easier for me, guys. You can't do this. You can't make PolitiFact your outsourced fact checker and then claim that you are merely a platform and not a publication. PolitiFact is a publication, and if you are just doing their bidding, you become a publication as well. Okay, this is dangerous stuff.